Yeah, I don't know. K. Rool is the third heaviest, second heaviest character.
I think so.
Yeah. Yeah, right behind Bowser.
And with all of that super armor, he's going to be kind of a menace in the center of the stage if he can take it.
Well, the face with up smash spikes.
What?
Yeah, the face with up smash spikes. It has a one frame spike downwards. It's his chin.
Okay.
Yeah, it's super hard to hit, and you've never seen it.
I kind of want to find that, but Pepino finding himself on the underside of PS2.
Getting pineappled.
Yeah, PS2 moment. That happens, unfortunately, but we see.
Oh. All right, I feel you. Luan coming out with that forward tilt there, using the weight there of his character to the full effect. It looks like Kripstar is using the Japanese name tag here. Yeah. It's a Tanoshi Sa.
Then we see the first Pokemon switch of the match.
Yellow Charizard, kind of cool though.
The PT back there looks really nice.
Oh, Flare Blitz.
All players kind of finding themselves safely back on stage. While Richter's recovery is like,
oh,
bad, that fair and back air are deceptively good. Was that
yeah.
a footstool upbeat?
Oh, footstool tear upbeat?
I need to try that.
Yeah.
That's
really
funny.
Cool. That was funny, man. I mean, Yuri's really good at avoiding the quote Belmont blind spot, as I call it, at the diagonal.
Yeah.
But it is there, and it will pose a problem. That's shield looking like a Skittle shield right now.
Yeah, but right now, Yuri holding down an anchor as Luhan and Pepino kind of struggle a little bit, but Yuri finally losing that first stock.
Luhan's taking a lot of hits there with his face, but it's okay, you can take it.
Yeah. You could kind of face tank as K. Rool for your teammate. It really helps out a lot.
It do. I mean, K. Rool, the fact that K. Rool has two projectiles, the suction move, and what is effectively two back airs?
Yeah.
So,
I'm not going to lie. I just saw Yuri center stage, hold jab, and do the little spin.
Oh, the Castlevania 4 meme? Yeah.
I love it. But
that was untechable there, that back air coming out.
Yeah, Luhan back airing his own teammate. That was death.
It's not good. There we go. Going to smash. Put Yuri there offstage. These forward tilts from Luhan are really actually, or for Luan. Yeah, Luan, they're really coming out. They're doing a lot of work right now. So, meanwhile, Squirtle, Kripstar using that PT to get some Squirtle ladder combos going.
Yeah, but every time Squirtle gets hit, I am in mortal fear that he is about to die.
Yeah, you can. Uh-oh. No way. The
no.
Japanese K. Rool? Funny Japanese K. Rool move. So you use the propeller and you kill him off the top.
Yeah, this is surprisingly even by looking at percents, but Yuri has been holding on to that second stock, and right now it is no longer close.
That down air just absolutely deletes Luan there. Kripstar saying, get off of my turn, bro. This is my stage. Goodbye. Pepino finding himself in between a rock and a hard place.
Oh, I thought a swing with a back air would have been certain for Kripstar there.
Uh-oh. Yeah, there we go. Four tilt. Yep. See ya.
That seemed like a pretty good amount of synergy.
That was a pretty good synergy there. They were admittedly a little bit all over the place. But hey, man, you know, when you've got Yuri's notoriously mobile Belmont.
Yeah.
So he's not a campy guy. He'll chase you around the map and trap you anywhere he wants. He's like, this is my house.
Yeah. You see a nice jump and then just immediate F tilt, recognizing his teammates out of the way now.
Right.
I can swing.
All right, peace. I'm out of here. Lylat. On twos?
Is that legal?
Is this allowed? Oh, okay.
I don't think so. No.
No.
Go to Unova.
Ban percent.
You won't.
Go to Unova. Go to Unova.
I really like that stage.
It's a cool stage.
It's cool just stage. Got the unfortunate teleport trainer. Issue.
It's really dark.
It is also very dark.
Yeah. Can sometimes be pose an issue. It was legal at the very beginning.
It was legal
game?
At the very beginning, and then right. Palu's teleport broke on it.
Oh, so FOD was also legal, I think, and then Zelda's teleport broke on that one because the fact that if you go underneath the lip, don't worry. Oh, okay, already. All right, we got the best music in the game. We got targets. This is literally only 30 seconds, but this is quite literally the best music in Melee.
I don't know, man. Mob Smash is also very
Mob
good.
Mob Smash, shout out to the community who got the Melee target record. Break the target's collective record under 7 minutes. And you shave off frames and you brag about it.
Dude, I've been watching a lot of
Salt.
No, like TAS breaking
uh-huh.
Break the targets in Melee. They go crazy.
The Bowser one is RNG-based.
Huh?
The Bowser one is completely RNG-based because of the neutral B.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's like you can go for a good time by using more RNG, or you can go for a probably like a more decisive lesser time by not using it.
Okay.
It's very strange.
It seems like very competitive and interesting.
Yeah, it's speed running and Smash. It's kind of strange.
Yeah, man.
If
Luan can just find a little bit of space to not hit his teammate, I think they've been pretty good.
Right, Luan's been using forward tilt to great effect, finding a good amount of kill options, and creating a lot of space with it, and using these Smash attacks to really cover a lot of distance, especially in center stage. But the problem is he often finds himself hitting his teammate, and those Smash attacks do a lot of damage.
So. Yes, they do. And right now we see Curbstari taking the role of stock tank in this game, as Yuri found his stock taken a little early, but it doesn't really matter because Curbstari and Yuri are covering for each other phenomenally.
Definitely. Charizard, one of the heavier characters. Not as heavy as K-Rool, but you know, acting as that anchor. There we go, that back air. Over the years here, man, Charizard has gotten innumerable buffs that have just kind of made him more than just a scary character.
Yeah.
Using that Flare Blitz, getting back on the stage and suffering at the hands of both of his opponents there.
Yeah, that dash attack's absolutely brutal around that point of the stage. Most places at 5% you'll just die to it though, but Luan, an unfortunate air dodge getting his stock taken to a Richter forward throw.
Yeah, Richter actually has some decent kill throws. It's a little bit surprising considering it's like, oh, a zoner having kill throws? Like,
yeah.
I thought Samus only had that, bro. Like, that's kind of weird.
It's especially dangerous right at that ledge because they have so much, like, base knockback.
Yeah.
That at that high percent, you don't really need much knockback growth to fight and killing.
No, you just, like, if they do neutral get up and you want to predict it, you can, like, okay, I can kill you. I don't need F smash or F till I just throw
and
you.
Richter absolutely has the tools to force a neutral get up with Curbstari missing a tech there and kind of losing a little bit of the stock tanking that he had going.
And Curbstari only down to one stock. The red team finding themselves at one stock. Yuri is barely holding on to two. Just trying his best here to hold left side of stage. Pepino's just trying to find a way in right now. You know, it doesn't help. Oh, no.
Yeah,
oh, okay.
That
just
was
like
unfortunate.
That. Yeah, that was unfortunate. I was about to say, you know, Lucina is often when paired with a heavy character can be made of glass.
All right. I saw a couple.